So welcome to the morning's panel of the last Monday, which was thought of to be as a platform for a bit of wrap-up, but also for reflection and focus on the topics that we covered this past 2 days. And you are invited to participate also during this panel, let's say, discussion, which will be introduced by Krunoslav Stojakovic and Katerina Kolozova. I will invite them both to reflect mainly on still persisting priority, be it urgent or less urgent, in the terms in which Chernyshevsky framed it a few hundred years ago, on the issue of what is to be done. That is basically, how do we move to the future? And then the past days, we've touched upon different aspects and different issues. We talked about populism, whether it's good or bad, what kind of populism, to embrace it, not to embrace it. Is it possible to import this political model from Latin America to Europe? We talked also about whether we should focus on national European, beyond European internationalist strategies to fight the different modes of exploitation. And also we talked about how much we can rely on, what we can rely on from the rich history that we have as a heritage from the partisan struggle. So there are many thoughts and ways and visions on how to move to the future, or basically to try to approach this question of what is to be done. So here I will invite first Krunoslav and then also Katerina to give some inputs, and then immediately also you feel invited to contribute with your comments.
So, hello everybody. Maybe I will start to map, in a way, the status quo of the left in the region. In the region means Southeast Europe, former Yugoslavia, Bulgaria, Romania and Albania. We have comrades here from Bulgaria and from Romania. Dani is not anymore here, unfortunately, for the Albanian case. All in all, I think it's obviously that the left, the radical left in the region, is very weak. We are faced with many problems on different levels, from organizational to political problems. But I lived very long in Germany, as you can hear from my German-English accent. In a way, the problems are not different to the problem the left is facing with in Germany or somewhere else. Maybe the only difference is that in the end, the left in Germany is, in a way, they succeeded in this step to become a political formation, a political organization in the form of the left party. But besides the left party in Germany, there are several other leftist groups, organizations, who are also debating about how to correspond and how to behave in the question of the political party, are they supporting the left in the parliament, in their parliamentary work, or not? In a way, similar questions are also in the region on the political platform. When I came to the region, to Belgrade, 4 years ago, I would say the left in the region was much more weaker than it is now. Even if we are, when we are looking on the left scene, on the radical left scene, we can see that it is weak, but 4 years ago we have been much more weaker. So there is a progress in a way, and but in several countries the situation is different. For example, in Slovenia, I would say the radical left is they succeed in a way to overcome or to make the next step from activism in different forms, from student uprising or trade unionism, to establish a political party, and they are now in the Slovenian parliament together with two other left liberal organizations under the umbrella of the United Left. But the discussions are still going on inside inside the initiative for social for socialism, for democratic socialism, because it is always a question how to relate to parliamentarism, for example. And in a way, they are quite this umbrella organization called United Left in Slovenia. In a way, they are quite successful. They are well recognized, and due to some opinion polls, they are the third political organization in Slovenia with, I don't know, 15 or 16%. And when they get into the parliament, they get 6%. So on this level, it seems that they are very successful. But inside the organization, inside the umbrella of United Left, there are several discussions that have to be made, but discussions with the potential to maybe also destroy in a way this umbrella coalition, and also in a way to be a problem for the initiative for democratic socialism. On the question, do we want to do parliamentary work, or do we want to be more activists? And these two fractions are now in great discussions. I do not know, no one knows what the result will be in the end, but potentially it can be very negative on the current state for the left in Slovenia. But these questions are very important. They have to be they have to discuss these questions, and I think not this part of the Slovenian left that is more in the area of parliamentary work, nor the part that is more on the activistic level, are wrong. Both in this situation, I think both fractions are right when they are saying that parliamentary work is necessary, because all of this parliamentary work, we are visible, we can try at least to make political changes. And on the other side, the more activistic sections who are argumenting that the work on the basis with workers, with other activists, on the local level, that this is important to empower the left. I think both are needed. The only question is how the internal discussion process will be and to which conclusions they will come. In Croatia, the left is, for me, from my perspective, a paradoxical situation. I would say, in a quantitative way, the left in Croatia is maybe the most powerful left in the region, quantitative. But they are not in organizational meaning. They are not organized in any way. There are several dozens of different organizations who are sometimes working together, but mostly working on their own agendas. Until now, I would say, besides the Comrade Luka is. I do not know where he is, but there have been attempts also to form a political party called Radnička fronta, Workers' Front. It's very questionable how this organization is functioning and what their political outreach can be in the way it is organized right now. But the left in Croatia is unfortunately in this moment not really good organized, and they are also not willing, I would say, at this moment to make the step to organize in a more formal way through a single political organization. What is also in a way okay, they are doing this part of activistic work on the local level with different actors, workers, migrants, on several topics. And there are also what is in Croatia, it until the new government was established, the public impact of the left in Croatia, I would say, was pretty high in comparison to other countries in the region. With the new government, it became more complicated, and we will see how the situation will be going on, because in September or something like that, there will be new elections in Croatia, and definitely also a new politic towards how the state is referring to this non-governmental sector. Bosnia-Herzegovina is maybe the most complicated. I would not say it's complex, because it's not complex, it's only complicated. Because the state is not existing as a state. It's divided. To have a passport is not it's not the same as to be a functional state. The left in Bosnia and Herzegovina, there have been several attempts on the left in Bosnia and Herzegovina. For example, 2 years ago there was this uprising started in Tuzla, in the north of Bosnia and Herzegovina, and then pretty fast spreading all over the country, all over the Federation of Bosnia and Herzegovina mostly. It was a social movement, and very in a very democratic way organized with local plenums, and the people in the left in Bosnia tried to overcome the status quo. But after several months, it most obviously that under these circumstances and with this power relations in Bosnia-Herzegovina between the Federation and between then the other part of Bosnia-Herzegovina called Republika Srpska, it was not possible to act in this way because the political elites in both parts of Bosnia-Herzegovina and Federation of Bosnia and in the Republika Srpska, in a way they tried to manipulate the protests in a nationalist way so that the people in Republika Srpska get the feeling that it is, Muslim Croat action against the Serbs, and in the Federation it was presented from the political elites as that is a kind of provocation of several forces in the Republika Srpska to destabilize the Federation. So in the end the outreach was maybe not as high as it was intended, but there are some obstacles from this protest, especially in Tuzla, where radical left organizations at least are trying to support local workers and the local workers movement, in this case the workers of Dita. It's a kind of trade union support with those workers who are organized in this factory, who try to, in a self-managed way, make this factory functional. It is open how it will end, because it is this factory is several times privatized, but the privatization process was, as in most cases, was failed, and the workers are now trying to take this factory and to self-organize inside this factory. But of course, they do not have any capital to ensure the production. And then maybe in Serbia it's also a very interesting situation, because the left in Serbia is now under the umbrella of Levi Summit Serbia, which consists of dozens of different political organizations who are sometimes connected with each other, but sometimes also not really connected, but who are thinking that they have to be organized inside this bigger umbrella organization called Levi Summit. And it is, I would say, it is a big outreach for the Serbian left, which was and is fragmented in several minor political organizations or NGOs or whatever, as an attempt to unite those forces. But the problems inside Levi Summit should be, in a way, the well-known problems the left is facing everywhere, and that is how to organize, on which political agenda to organize. And it is an open discussion process since, I would say, 2 or 3 years. And it's also open how this discussion process will in the end be. But generally, I would say that only the fact that we have this Levi Summit Srbije is very positive for the left in Serbia to become more visible in the public, because until now, this very little, sometimes very dogmatic political organizations do not have any outreach in the public, and Levi Summit makes a big difference in this way. But the question is, like in other cases, on which platform, how to organize. Do we need a single organization, or is it more practicable to act through different organizational forms? And in the end, the left in Macedonia in the past few years, I would say, also make a big step forward with all the problems that they are facing with. And also in Macedonia, one of the crucial questions was when the social movement grows and becomes more visible in the public and mobilize more and more people, what should and what could be the next step? And of course, then it is always a question of political party or to form a political organization. And the discussion process in Macedonia was also very complicated and very hard, with many discussions when the left in Macedonia was formed. Is it now the right time to form a political party, or is it maybe too early, because we are in the end too weak to make this step? And this may be also an ongoing discussion process until now in Macedonia. Even the party exists, but I think the discussions on this question and how the party should act or should be organized, I think that's, that will be in discussion also in the next time. And so all in all, there is an improvement of the left, but there are crucial open questions that we are facing with. And from my point of view, we also have, we have this in a way in the discussion with Gal, and also in the discussion yesterday with Santiago. What is the left, and what should the politics of the left be? From my point of view, maybe the biggest one of the most important agendas for the left is also in this case of what is left populism, is that the left, in a way, we do not have a meta-narrative which would be for the public or for the outer space of the left, something that could be detected. Okay, that's the left view on this crucial question that we are, that the societies are facing with. And if we are thinking about the left, we can in a way detect it, what the left is. We are so fragmentized, and we are dealing with several single topics. As Gal pointed it out, we are very good in criticizing and analyzing several problems of the societies and the contradiction between capital and work and labor, but we do not have anymore a meta-narrative. Our meta-narrative, I'm not able to tackle it in a way. We have several ideas on several topics, but no meta-narrative that could be that could mobilize the society in the way the left was able to mobilize society in the past time. And the question of the European Union and Brexit, and to end with this, it's maybe a classical point, what happens when you do not have a meta-narrative. So there are several leftist groups who are in favor that Britain is leaving the European Union. You have several leftist groups who are criticizing that Britain is leaving the European Union. Both have some arguments that I can completely understand and I completely share, but both also have arguments that are in a way only a reaction on the other point of view, and are more an effect of the inside left discussion than an effect of analyzing really the structural problems of the EU. That's, for example, I would say it's a very big problem for the left, that the left, the radical left, is not until now able to give leftist answer and then leftist project, counter project to the European Union. For me, it is not enough to say Slovenia, Bulgaria, Romania or Croatia should leave the EU, and then in Croatia, Slovenia, Bulgaria and Romania everything will be fine. It's completely nonsense. We do not have an idea what should be for the left the next step or a counter project to the EU. And I think, as for me as a leftist, a return to national states is surely not the answer to the problems of the European Union.
Thank you, Krono. Thank you for giving us an interesting oversight of the political situation of what we call the left or the new left in the Balkans. And yes, of course, it seems like this in some countries where we have better developments in terms of structure, we have deeper discussions in terms of disagreement. So that's basically what the left is. It's about discussing and disagreeing. To contribute this discussion from another perspective, Katerina can show some ideas.
If it doesn't work, I can tell you this.
Yeah, it's working.
Okay. So I'll move on. Then we won't be needless. Let it be. All right, so I will begin basically from where Krunov stopped. I would like to point out to you a recent publication, a book that came out last year called Inventing the Future by Nick Cernichek and Alex Williams, that analyzes in a very convincing way the limitations of the concept and the practice of activism we are familiar with, and it is the only form of activism actually we are familiar with at the moment, and also problematizes the fact that activism, horizontal activism, is actually the main form of political action for the radical left, or the left which is not the center. So they begin the analysis. I'm not going to retell the book. It's important to make several points. First of all, it's important to read it because it's the first, I believe, systemic analysis of the limitations of what we do. It's also at the same time a philosophical analysis because it goes into the ontology of this horizontal activist movements of the Occupy type. So we have a model for this, and that is the model we all practice basically, and that is a model that the authors also come from. And it's not that much ontological, as it is an epistemological problem. They identify this problem of reason there, which is which they call reason, the reason of folk politics. By folk, they mean something which is not systemically thought through. and that these folk politics that, that they identify us all enacting in our horizontal movements, again, I will emphasize, of the occupied type. So there is a type, there is a model, and we're following a certain model. It's not like something that grew out of the practice spontaneously. So they both point out that there are this sort of gestures of spontaneity of thought, which are not systemically or not in any way thought through or reflected upon. And they insist that there is this cult, almost cult of immediate action, of immediacy, as it is a reaction, it's an act of immediateness, so right now at the moment. So there is no time or concept of action that would enable you to think systemically and long term. So what they say is that we actually lack political thought, that we are caught up in reactivity, or in a reactive reason, in a format of action, action which is NGO style, and which is just a continuation of the old bourgeois tradition, and without being captives of this category, who is bourgeois, who is communist, who is captive in reactionary reason, or who is the propagator of a progressive reason. So they even don't go into this distributing of labels. They just point out to the limitations in terms of format and in terms of pseudo ideology. This is why they call it folk politics, because it's not even proper politics, it's pseudo ideology of reaction, of protest. And the big question they raise is the centrality of the concept of protest. So if you are a protest movement all the time, if your organizations are centered around the protest, and if this vague idea, empty of any ideology of protest, is what defines you, that you are, then you are even more complicit in maintaining the status quo of neoliberalism or the format of capitalism we're witnessing now, than forming a party and joining the political system and making substantive political change through the parliament. You can influence laws, you can influence policies, you can change the constitution, you can carry out the long dreamt revolution after all. I mean, you need to be a political subject. The vague category of activism, and it is vague. When we say left activism, what do we mean? What makes it left? If it's empty of political content, if what it is filled with is just protest against small actions here and there of injustice done by the state, then what makes it different than, I don't know, the club of women in Skopje who organize competitions in cake making, because they also join this type of protests. So, it's called Tortillada. It's a festival. So, activism, left activism, to me, is activism which is aiming toward political change and which is aiming to become some sort of participant in the existing parliamentary system. I mean, we do not live in outer space. We live on this planet, on this continent, and we live in parliamentary democracies. If we do not wish to be solid by the parliamentary democracies, then we shouldn't be even activists at all. We shouldn't protest, because whom are you interpolating when you protest? You're legitimizing through your interpolation the existing institutions. So, to sum up, to me, it's a false dilemma. It's a falsity. Faux dilemma. Activism versus party. It's an empty dilemma. It's empty because of the reasons I just presented. Let's take the case of Macedonia. We have a couple of political NGOs, which according to me are political because they aim toward certain ideological change, certain political change, and that should be a change which affects the system, the political system. They are not political or not left by being merely activists. This is what I'm saying. So even when we say activism, we should look at what defines activism in order to call it left activism. Currently, we're witnessing still, I think, I'm not sure, the so-called colorful revolution, which is a movement against the existing government. It accomplished certain things. I mean, the former prime minister resigned. Now the movement is obsessing whether he might want to return. I think that we haven't witnessed another country with similar movements where when the movement overthrows somebody in power, they protest out of worry that the person might get back to power. So it's even politically completely vague. Nonetheless, I don't want to bother you with localism. My point is that all of us, so I'm not accusing any organization, all of us, including myself, and including the party as member of Levica, have been submerged into this colorful revolution for months, which is something which is completely ideologically undefined, which is defined by the mere opposition to the existing, not even elites, mind you. It's siding with the existing opposition. The biggest opposition party. So it lacks any ideological definition. And here we see Levica as a victim of its own activist inertia. Levica has been acting like, I'm criticizing the party I belong to at the moment. So, not being partial. I think we need to open this debate. Levica is out of certain spontaneity, being part of the so-called colorful revolution, and it has been acting for months as a part of the protest movement, as an activist group. It does not have a profile of a party there. The movement might be headed by the biggest opposition party, the Social Democrats, but at least we know this is a party and they act like a party. So there is a whole problem there of vague activism, of activism already for the sake of activism, lacking political definition. And as long as we do not deconstruct the sanctity of the idea of activism and do not see the empty shell behind the word, even our attempts to start a party and introduce a proper political change through the parliament will fail, because the spontaneity, the inertia of being an activist is what is dominant. And so again, like after Gal's session, I'm not being, some Bolshevik here, insisting on party politics as the only option. I'm just pointing out to the syndrome of activism we all suffer from, which blinds us from the possibilities of effective political action and hence change. So even the groups I belong to, I identify as problematic in this sense. I identify myself as problematic in this sense. So I'm not judging anybody. I was part of the protest movements for movement for at least a month. I left it when they started mocking the poor people, the workers supporting Vomero. So, and maybe here we arrive also to the issue of outreach. So the activism itself, it's keeping also Levica among, let's call them cultural elite, middle class, and wrapped up in a language which communicates only with highly educated people. Not only it does not provide channels for communication for itself with the workers and the ordinary peoples, those that are bought with a sandwich, allegedly, by the ruling party. It even produces language, codes of communication which denigrate ordinary people. When this mocking with the sandwich started happening, I wanted to ask the mockers, okay, what is their price if the price of the Bambaro supporter is just a sandwich? And tell me, what is your price? I mean, is this a language of a leftist movement? I'm sorry. I mean, this flaws in not just rhetoric, these are flaws in stance, according to me, come from the unchecked notion of activism we all spontaneously enact. So.